All right, welcome back, guys. About 4 months ago, I bought an RCI 1 gallon 5051 aluminum fuel cell for my bike. And I'm planning on running E85 in it. So I looked it up and it didn't say anything about E85. It didn't say if it was safe for E85. And it's made out of 5051 aluminum. I did some search on Google and I couldn't really come up with anything, if it was safe to use. And I didn't want to use it and then find out that, it's not compatible and I have all that trash going to my fuel system. Fuel injectors, fuel filter, fuel pump, and destroy the whole fuel system. So what I did is I cut a small piece of it and I put it in a E85 about 4 months ago, and I'm about to pull it out and see if there's any damage to the aluminum. If there is, I'm gonna have to change the plan and probably use 110 VP fuel instead of E85. It's not something that I wanted to do, but I don't want to damage my fuel system, so let me pull it out and see what it looks like. So here it is, small piece of aluminum, and I don't see any damage to it. I don't see any corrosion. It's not soft. It's still the same as it was 4 months ago. So I'm kind of happy to see that because I really like to run E85 on my bike. Otherwise, if I can't run it, I can't run pump gas because it's a 12.7 to 1 static compression in the engine, and it's got a turbo. So 80, 93 octane would probably work, but not really good. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the piece back in there. And I'm gonna put it back in the garage. And I'm gonna see what would happen in another 4 months. So I'll try to make a update video if anything changes. So and that's about it. So far, no problems.